Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today's discussion is regarding Muslim leadership and the responsibilities. A leadership is a great job and great quality for the human nature. Due to the lack of this leadership, whole Muslim ummah is in turmoil. We can observe, we can see ourselves what is happening around the Muslim world. There are so many leaders, but in reality, there is none who can lead the Muslim ummah in good and proper direction. Leadership is necessary for the success of any country, any organization, any financial conduct. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that if there are three people on a journey, one of them should be appointed as a leader to lead the nation. As Amir, Islam recognizes no collective worship, no collective prayers that is not organized. Even collective prayers is based on organization. We have been told when you do the prayers, no gap should be left in the rows of worshippers, standing shoulder to shoulder and foot to foot. It is a unit of movement and appearance as much as it is a unity of doctrine and direction. Prophet has said, do not differ so that your hearts may not differ. Nobody is allowed to break the rank. Should the imam make a mistake, and it is the responsibility and duty of those men and women who are behind him to rectify his mistake. Leadership based on the Quran has a purpose of preserving the humanity, preserving the society, preserving the existence of the nation, maintaining, sustaining, and implementing the objectives, as well as serving the needs of any country, any organization, individual, or society. The best undisputed leader for the Muslim Ummah, for us to emulate, is the leadership of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in affairs of the world and the hereafter. Based on the words of Allah in Surah Ahzab, I can translate here just لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رُسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. There has certainly been for you in the Messenger of Allah an excellent pattern, excellent example, excellent way of life for anyone whose hope is in Allah and the last day of the judgment. The importance of this leadership encompasses all facts of life, particularly in the discipline of Islamic management, Islamic organizations. This is clearly projected by our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself in administering the matters of Sharia smoothly and properly. Though the management of Islamic dawah preaching is given special attention by him to ensure it is going well. The importance of consultation shura cannot be separated from the concept of Islamic leadership, and Quran emphasis on it. Allah says in Surah Shura, and those who have responded to their Lord and established prayers and whose affairs is determined by consultation among themselves, and from what we have provided them, they spend. Based on this verse, Shura is an ideal way, a model, a way of life to control the leader and guide him on different matters. Now, a leader should have a different quality and capability to lead the nation. A capability and the qualifications of a leader is very important in Islamic leadership. The three aspects which ensure a capable leader are, number one, physical ability, number two, spiritual evolution, number three, exceptional mental ability. These three qualities will make a good leader to run the country, run the society, run any organization. A leader must be a trustworthy person. He must know his colleagues, his countrymen, and the team who is leading, he must be mindful of the need for the development of the country and community projects or those who are associated with that, with him or with his organization. He must provide training programs and establish schools, colleges and university for his own country people. He must exercise a correct decision, and he should be the decision maker, and sometimes he need to take the tough decision with the consultation of others. Leaders must be a good decision makers and must display appreciation for the diversity and the multiculturalism. I may conclude saying the best leader qualified is in all aspects would ensure a good organization and a good framework. Islamic leadership is required by Islam, is that which was shown by our beloved Prophet, as Quran has saying, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظًا قَلْبَ إِلَىٰ آخِرِهِ. It can be translated, it was thanks to Allah's mercy that you were gentle to them. Had you been rough, hard-hearted, they would surely have scattered away from you. So pardon them and pray for their forgiveness and take counsel from them in the matters of importance. And when you are resolved on a course of action, place your trust in Allah. Surely Allah loves those who put their trust in Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and give us tawfiq to follow the footsteps of Prophet and lead the nation in a proper way. Jazakumullahu khair. Asana al-jaza.